Alright guys, here's a 1v1 here. This is actually a replay of the live battle that I showed you guys last. Me versus Rex Zilbs of the BIA clan. And you guys saw that it was a very good battle. Very good battle. Very close. But I just wanted to give a little bit more attention to it because it's actually a very tactically intense battle, and I didn't really have time or the focus to actually talk too much about strategies while I was in battle. So I just wanted to give you guys this replay here so I could talk more about the strategies that we both employed and basically the what was going on, because at times it definitely did seem hectic. At least that's what I think. The live battle did seem hectic at times. Anyway, so we're going to zoom down here onto the battlefield. Okay, so let's see. I split my army into two groups, as most of you probably saw from the replay. This group over here consisted of one unupgraded Bow Warrior Monks out in front, followed up by a 4 Chevron Matchlock Ashigaru. This, in turn, was followed by an unupgraded Yari Ashigaru. These Yari Ashigaru were just to protect my missiles, my ranged units, from his cavalry. Then I had two units of, or at least in this group, one unit of 7 Chevron No-Dachi here, followed by two 6 Chevron Katana Samurai here, in the blue and gold. And these Katana Samurai are going to be very, very important in this battle, as I'm sure you guys saw from the live battle. And I've also got in this group my Avatar's Bodyguard here, and he is wearing the awesome silver, red, and gold armor here, the nice tall hats and the so he looks very nice at the moment. Then let's look at the other group over here. There we go, just had to turn on the flags just to make it easier. On this group I also have another unupgraded Bow Warrior Monk, followed by a 4 Chevron Matchlock Warrior Monk, so these guys are better than my Matchlock Ashigaru. They are also followed by an unupgraded Yari Ashigaru, a 7 Chevron No-Dachi, one 5 Chevron Katana Samurai, and a 6 Chevron Lone Sword Ashigaru. Then I have 6 units of light cavalry here. I chose light cavalry and a lot of them because if you can micromanage your cavalry well enough, 2 light cavalry can take out a Yari cavalry. They'll both be very depleted, but they can do it, and they cost as much as a Yari cavalry unit. So in my opinion, if you can really micromanage your troops well, then they are slightly more cost effective if you bring a large quantity of them. Also, though they cannot in no way take out a Great Guard, they can slow Great Guard and Katana Cavalry and Warrior Monk Cavalry down enough to fix the situation with spear units. So I have one of them in the trees over here, two of them supporting on this flank here, then I have one of them out here, and two of them in the trees over here. My opponent has started out with his forces very bunched up in here. Basically, what he has is one unit of Naginata Samurai here. Then he has two units of Bow Warrior Monks. One of these guys has 9 chevrons. Then he has a unit of Matchlock Warrior Monks. And then he has, I think, 3 units of Lone Sword Ashigaru and 2 Katana Samurai. And 2 Yari Ashigaru as well. Once his formation spreads out, it'll be slightly easier. But what he's going to do is he's going to send out a group over here, try and capture this workshop over here. This group consists of a Yari Ashigaru, a Katana Samurai, and a Lone Sword Ashigaru. And his center has the 2 Bow Warrior Monks, Naginata Samurai and the Matchlock Warrior Monk, as well as 2 Lone Sword Ashigaru and a Katana Samurai and his Avatar. And his Yari Ashigaru over here as well. Eventually, his Yari Ashigaru, 1 Katana Samurai, and 1 Lone Sword go off onto his right flank. Also hidden in these trees, somewhere around here, he has 2 units of highly upgraded Great Guard and a Katana Cavalry unit. Okay, so what am I doing here? As I am sure you guys saw in the replay, I have grouped my my army into 2 separate groups here, both of around equal strength, and I've sent this group on my left over here to try and take this Sword Dojo here to give my units increased melee attack. And I initially tried to send my whole entire group over here to get the shrine, but I saw that his whole entire force was over here, and by quickly looking at the flags visible, like these tiny little flags, these actually show the number of upgrades. Unfortunately, his flag is completely black, which means that sometimes it's difficult to count. Like this unit, it has 9 chevrons, it looks like, from the flag. But sometimes it's hard to count just by looking at them. But I saw that he had pretty much his whole entire force was over here. He had cavalry somewhere, but I had to keep a lookout. So I have 1 unit of light cavalry over here just to support my Lone Sword Ashigaru, which I sent over here to try and take the shrine. And I've taken my groups here. Over here, I'm taking some light cavalry, and these guys are going to start skirmish. My initial cavalry is actually very poor here. So in comes my light cav here in loose formation. They're getting shot at by his 9 chevron bow warrior monks, matchlock warrior monks, etc., etc. So I'm going to try and get them in to do a little bit of damage here. But he's going to support with his blue warrior monks in here. So these are his blue warrior monks. And they're going to dice up my cavalry. Over here, I tried to send in another cavalry unit, but it just got shot by his matchbox. And it did very little damage as well. I'm going to try and withdraw them away. But they're already broken here. So my initial cavalry skirmish failed drastically. This unit over here was shattered. And this one over here is broken. It does come back from routing right around here. But I did lose that unit in the beginning. It's okay, though, because I have 6 units, so I still have 4 units. One of which is being shot up here slightly. I didn't notice it until after they had lost 6 men. And you can see over here that this unit does come back from routing as it nears my general. So these guys do come back from routing. My other 2 units of light cavalry that are in the forest here, they have moved up here and are hidden. And his forces are over here, and I do want to try and take out his archers, because his archers are better than mine, significantly better than mine. Even though he has only 1 matchlock, and I have 2 matchlocks, his matchlock is better than mine, and his archers are better than mine, so I really need to try and take out, or at least weaken his archers enough to allow my infantry to close without getting too injured. Okay, so I'm going to speed up the battle just here, just a little bit, because it is going to be a little bit slow. In the live replay, I cut out a little bit of this footage here, because it's just me moving my guys around. He's going to try and approach with these units over here on this flank. Over here, I've managed to capture the shrine and the sword dojo. I'm going to put back into play mode now. You can see that he's now approaching with these this flank over here and his main body over here. And so my cavalry is here, and I don't want them to get seen yet. But they're in a good position right here. Eventually, when he starts to move forward his main force a little bit more, I'll be able to charge into his archers with my light cavalry. What I'm doing to try and lure him farther in is I'm going to withdraw up here. I also definitely do not want this his group over here to get the high ground against me, so I am withdrawing slightly up here to try and get the better hill advantage. And with this group over here, I am going to withdraw that group up just a little bit up closer as well. Over here, I've noticed that his group over here, I could potentially try and flank it with my Lone Sword Ashigaru. Right now, his Yari Ashigaru is just getting shot by my Bow Warrior Monks, which is actually, I don't know. They only have, 2 chevrons? 2 chevrons because of the 2 little black flags. But it's always good to try and get rid of a unit if you can, and I've already done 56 casualties there. So that's going well over there. With this Lone Sword Ashigaru unit, I'm going to bring it over here. But eventually over here, his cavalry, I might have missed it, but his cavalry appears around here for just a tiny touch. Yes, it was right here. I'm going to charge in my light cavalry here. My light cavalry is going to get into his bow warrior monks because these guys are hidden and he didn't realize it. So I'm going to smash in there. He's going to try and support with his warrior, Naginata Samurai over there. And also his cavalry back here is going to become unhidden. So he's got 2 Great Guard and a Katana cavalry. With that, I'm going to withdraw this unit of Lone Swords back into those forests over there to hide them. Over here, my strike-in is very, very successful. This unit begins to waver, having lost half of its men. But I'm actually going to get both of those units away without routing. For a relatively good damage against his Bow Warrior Monks here, I've dealt 28 casualties to one of them and 6 casualties to the other with that charge. That was a very effective charge by me, very worth my 2 light cavalry units. And of course, my Lone Sword Ashigaru here is slightly isolated. If it gets charged by Great Guard or Katana Cavalry, these guys will fall. So I am going to now withdraw them into the forest, and I'm going to leave them there for actually most of the battle. This might not have been very wise. It might have been smart to try and take them out and involve them in the main fight earlier, but I did not do that. As you can see over here, I've now withdrawn my 2 groups. It's kind of like a single force split up. I've got my cavalry to hold the center here just to link up my 2 sides I'm moving this side a little bit closer in. And, yeah, so at this point, the live recording has re-engaged. I re-engaged it before my cavalry charge. So this stuff is all part of the live replay. Pretty soon here, he begins to march up with his groups. You can see there he goes. He's going to march up with his right flank again over here. So these guys are going to march up. Remember, this group consists of a Yari Ashigaru, a Katana Samurai, and a Lone Sword Ashigaru. And although his Lone Sword Ashigaru are 9 Chevron, and his Katana Samurai are, I believe, 9 Chevron as well, I'm going to try and use my No-Dachi and my 2 Katana Samurai. So basically, I do have a slight infantry advantage here. I have 4 swords, and he has 5 swords, but 3 of his swords are lone swords, whereas only 1 of mine is a lone sword. So I have 3 Katana Samurai to his 2. So I have that advantage right there. Plus I have 2 units of No-Dachi, and he only has 1 unit of 90 Samurai to support. He does have 2 Yari Ashigaru, I have 2 Yari Ashigaru. So I do have the infantry advantage here, and I do notice this, and I'm going to try and use my infantry to win me this battle, because he has the archer advantage and the cavalry advantage. So at this point, the archer fight has engaged, and here I'm going to bring up my my light tower here, just to make him think about it, and you can see that I'm moving them around to dodge his fire arrows here. You can see his fire arrows, they're going to thud into nothingness over here. So I am wasting some of his fire arrows and his ammunition here against my light cavalry. My light cavalry will rout, but as you notice, I'm not actually charging them in. I'm just using them in loose formation as a distraction. And what this is allowing is my bow warrior monks over here to get free shots in. So my guys have not been not taken a single casualty yet. Unfortunately, I did not notice this until a little bit too late. My bow warrior monks are firing against this Yari Ashigaru, and they're doing quite a few casualties. They've dealt 14 casualties already, but I definitely do not want to be targeting his lone swords. I definitely want to be targeting his Mashok warrior monks or bow warrior monks instead. Okay, so over here, my bow warrior monks have again started to fire into his Yari Ashigaru over here, I believe. Yes. Gonna do a couple casualties here, a couple casualties there, like this guy. This is just an overflow, but I managed to take down that Katana Samurai right there. And here comes my flaming missiles. In for relatively no damage. He is stationed semi in the trees here, so that is also helping him, his cover right here. Plus, my bows are not upgraded, which is also something to notice. So I'm going to get a couple shots off here with my matchlocks. They don't do too much damage at all. What I've done with my light cavalry here, this is a wounded unit of light cavalry. I've run completely around his force over here to get them kind of mixed up, slow their advance while I get my infantry units up here onto the high ground to match them. And I'm going to take this light cavalry unit, I'm going to smash into his matchlocks and his lone swords from behind. This is going to actually be a very successful charge here, like that guy that got thrown. I'm going to do actually quite a few casualties to his Lone Sword Ashigaru. Unfortunately, his matchlocks get away, taking only 7 casualties, which is not ideal. And he does have his bow warrior monks in behind that are now going to pepper my sword units. My light cavalry, excuse me. So now here comes the infantry engagement. I'm going to send my No-Dachi charging in under the Banzai ability. I managed to engage that. I have a No-Dachi charging in against his Katana Samurai here. And my No-Dachi have a much better charge bonus, better melee statistics, I'm guessing. So my No-Dachi are going to get the upper hand here relatively quickly. And in comes reinforcements, a wave tactic here. My Katana Samurai versus his. But I'm going to get the upper hand here. My Katana Samurai are very powerful, actually. You can see that my guy just absolutely decimated his Katana Samurai. And over here around the flank, I'm going to get this Katana Samurai around this flank and smash in from the side here. And his units are going to begin to waver. Over here, I've begun to take my units of Yari Ashigaru, put them into spear wall formation just to absorb bullets. Over here, I tried to get this Yari Ashigaru into spear wall formation, but I was too late. This was a mistake by me. And I'm also taking a couple friendly fire casualties, but nothing too major, because I am doing quite a few casualties to him as well with my matchlock warrior monks. However, Over here, you can see his Great Guard have come out of hiding, so I've charged him with my Light Cavalry. This is not to beat them, because his Great Guard are very superior to my Light Cavalry, especially as my Light Cavalry are unupgraded. My other Light Cavalry unit went right into his Matchlocks, so you're going to do a little bit of damage there. His Matchlocks are down to half strength. My Light Cavalry over here is not designed to win this fight, but I'm just slowing him down while my infantry manages to win this fight. And I'm going to try and take my Yariashigaro, and I'm going to try and support my archer units back here. So right here, my bows and my Matchlocks, these guys are unsupported against his incoming Katana Cavalry over here. So I'm going to try and get my spear unit back here to support. Over up here on the flank, I've managed to overwhelm his sword infantry, so he charged in his other Great Guard unit over here, just to slow down my guys over here. And I will manage to pull out the victory. I'm going to cut up these Great Guard here. And my other unit is just going to charge straight in against his Lone Swords and his Matchlocks. While over here, this is really what kind of won me the battle. His cavalry was so superior, but I managed to make them focus on my Bow Warrior Monks, while I got my Matchlock Warrior Monks out of there to continue their firing, and I got my sword units in just to bog down his cavalry, so my Matchlocks could continue to fire. Over here, he's getting dangerously close to my general, so I'm going to countercharge my Light Cav. Once again, I'm not trying to win this, I'm just trying to slow him down enough to get my general away from that engagement. And over here, you can see that his Great Guard is still annoyingly holding in there with 13 guys left, and my No-Dachi are trying to rout here with 22 guys left, but they're actually going to stick in there because I just rallied my troops with my general here, and I'm going to actually charge in against his Great Guard with my general. My general is a journeyman swordsman, so he's not awful. He's not great, but he's not awful. And there he is himself right there. And he's actually going to get pretty shot up by Matchlock fire in, over here. Over here comes my general, just chopping down the last of his Great Guard here. So I'm going to try and get my general around. I see that his general is in the stand and fight position here. So I'm going to take my general, and I'm going to decide to try and take out his general, who's right there. So here comes my general. My general is right there. And he's trying to hack up his guys, but unfortunately, very unfortunately for my army, there he goes. My general just died right there. He's going to be laying on the ground right here. So that was very bad for my army here, because he is a legendary leader, so the bonus to morale has also gone. Luckily enough, my units are superior enough to hold their ground. Over here, I've brought my Lone Sword out of hiding over there, and I'm targeting his Yariashigaro that were left behind. And my sword units have managed to come out victorious. So I'm shooting at his Matchlocks over here, causing some casualties with my Matchlock Warrior Monks. Sorry, those were his Bow Warrior Monks, not Matchlocks. And now I'm going to try and, unfortunately, my guys were right-clicked over here. And so they're just going to keep following in, which is unfortunate because here comes his Great Guard. I noticed this too late, so I'm going to try and get my Katana Samurai in there to support. I'm going to try and get these Matchlocks back very quickly as I possibly can, but they're going to take massive casualties. Fortunately for me, this is going to hold up his Great Guard long enough for my Katana Samurai to get in there and hold them. So over here, my Katana Samurai is actually beating up his units over here, Lone Swords and Matchlocks, Bow Warrior Monks over here. My Katana Samurai over here are really proving their worth here. 6 Chevron Katana Samurai here, chopping up his guys with ease. And, yes, unfortunately right there, my Katana Samurai are not routing. They were just supported by my No-Dachi here that charged in from downhill to try and attack his general here. And I'm going to take my Katana Samurai and I'm going to try and rush them off after his Matchlocks here, who he, I believe, forgot to put into the fire at will. He took them off fire at will to selectively fire them. That's a good idea. But he forgot to put them back. He forgot to re-engage fire at will, so these guys are not firing. And my Katana Samurai was just going to allow my Katana Samurai to get in there. Okay, so over here, what it's turned out is he has a unit of Great Guard with 18 men left, and this unit of Yariashigaro with 120 out of 150. And they're double-teaming my No-Dachi over here. And so I have that No-Dachi, it's down to a mere 35 men. Then I have this unit of Katana Samurai with 80 men, and that full unit of Lone Sword Ashigaro with 6 chevrons, remember, so those guys would pretty much win me the battle at this point. At this point, I knew that I would win this battle, because although Great Guard, Artillery, and No-Dachi are swords, No-Dachi actually do very well against cavalry, considering. So I was not very concerned at this point, not to mention that his general over here is wavering. His general has a mere 6 men left, and his general is soon going to actually rout here. And his great guard in here are trying their hardest. I downhill charged his Yariashigaru uphill charged him with my Katana Samurai, and he's gonna plow right through his Yariashigaru here with his great guard. So he's gonna do some damage to his own troops there, but he's gonna try and withdraw, but his units are wavering over here, and I'm gonna get my lone swords into this melee over here. And here come my lone sword Ashigaru. And these guys are very late to the battle. They barely got any kills, but they didn't take any losses either. And my Katana Samurai here just managed to overwhelm the last of his Yariashigaru over here. So my lone swords arrived just to claim victory here against his fleeing troops here. And at that point, his general routed, and my horde of infantry here, or not very big horde actually, just a very few units left, we managed to win this battle. So that was the end of the battle. It was very close, and it was a very, very good battle, and I really enjoyed it. It showed some pretty good tactics on both sides. Although it seemed hectic, there was order. And I just wanted to show you guys the replay so I can talk a little bit more about the actual tactics that went on. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed.